Hi children, good morning. How are you all? All are fine, isn't it? Fine and safe at home. Due to corona and rain, you are not going outside, you are staying at home, isn't it? Yeah, yes, very good. Stay at home and be safe. Before moving into our lessons, let me introduce myself first. I am Shirley, your new SS teacher. So now let us move to our lessons. Okay, we have already completed 4 blocks. Now we are moving into our 5th block. What's the name of our block? Any idea? What's the name of our block? Very good. The name of our block is our country. It is already written on the blackboard. Our country or my country. Then what's the name of our country? What's the name of our country? Very good. It is, what's the name of our country? It is India. So we are called Indians. People, those who are living in India is called Indians. No doubt for that, we all are Indians. We all are Indians. So now we are going to study more about India. More details about India. Okay. What do you know about India? What do you know about India? You already said India is our country. Again, what else you know about our country? What else you know about our country? Say fast. Very good. You know about states. Okay, very good. Again, what else? Union territories. Very good. Union territories, very good. Okay, these are the two topics we are going to discuss in detail today. India, states and union territories. These are the two things we are going to discuss today. So how many states are there in India? How many states are there? Very good. There are 29 states in India. Very good. 29 states are there in India. Then how many union territories are there in India? Very good. 7 union territories are there in India. 7 union territories and 29 states are there in our country. So, now next question. What is a state? Can you give me a definition? What is a state? Any definition? What is a state? What is a state? Give me the definition. What is a state? You said there are 29 states and 7 union territories. Then what is a state? Anybody? Huh? Okay, no problem. States are small parts of a country. Small parts of a country. States are small parts of a country. State is divided into many parts. So each part is known as our country is divided into many parts. The part of the country is known as a state. Is it clear? First, what is a state? States are the small parts of a country. Then again, what else you know about the state? It has its own government. Each state has its own government. Very good. Again, what else you know? Anything else you know? Yes, very good. State has capital, its own capital, its own government capital. Then, what is the name of our state? Very good, very good. Everybody know the name of our state. It is Kerala. Very good. Very good. Everyone knew the name of our state is Kerala. Then, which is the capital of Kerala? Capital of Kerala? Very good. That also everyone knew, that is Thiruvananthapuram. Again, Again, we said each state has its own government. That means there will be a chief minister and team to look after the matters of the state. Each state will have a chief minister and a team. Under the leadership of chief minister, a team is working. Different ministers and many other officers are working for the welfare of the state. So, who is our chief minister? Who is Kerala's chief minister? But who is it? Very good. Mr. Pinarayi Vijayan is our chief minister. Now it is clear. The states are the small parts of a country. So our state's name is Kerala. Again we discussed each state has its own capital. Kerala's capital is Thiruvananthapuram. Again each state has its own government under the leadership of chief minister. So our chief minister is now it is clear. Like that, all the state has its own systems. Then what is the specialty of capital? All the important officers are government employees or government offices are located in the capital. Capital is the most important city in a state. Each state has its own capital. Capital is the most important city in a state, and most of the important offices are there in the capital. Is it clear about the state? It is clear now? Yeah, very good. Now let us move to the union territories. What is the difference between state and union territory? Union territories are smaller than the state in area. They are smaller than the state. Again, they don't have their own government. They are directly under the control of central government. No state government. That is the difference. Union territories are directly under the control of central government. There is no state government. And in area, they are smaller than the state. These are the difference between states and union territories. Is it clear? We are discussing about India. India is divided into 29 states and 7 union territories. What is the importance of states? States are the small parts of a country. Each state has its own government capital. Then union territory, smaller than state, again directly under the control of a central government. These are about states and union territories. Is it clear? Okay. Now we are moving into location of the states. Location of the states. Location of states. Here is one map. India map is there. Outline map of India is here. See, before moving into the location of states, if we want to locate any place in an outline map, we should know about the directions and boundaries. If we want to locate or if we want to find out any place in an atlas, we should know about the directions and boundaries. So first let us check about the directions. Have you heard this word before, directions? I think in third class and all you might have studied. Directions. How many directions are there? Very good. How many? Four directions. Which are the four directions? North, South, East, West. North, South, East, West. These are the four major directions. Again, four sub-directions also. Northeast, northwest, southeast, southwest. Like that, four sub-directions also. You have learned it. So now, this is India's outline map. Here, where is north? You just tell me where is north. Where is north? Up or down? Very good. This position is north. This is north. Then where is south? Ah, very good. Down, south, east, west. Up is north, south, east, west. These are the four major directions. Then now again we have to discuss another one thing, that is boundaries of India. Which are the boundaries of India? What's mean by boundary? Four sides. Four sides. So what is there in the northern boundary of India? Any idea? What is the northern boundary of India? No idea. If you do not know, you should learn and don't forget it. You should keep it in your mind. Even in the higher class also, many children are there. They do not know which are the boundaries of India. So you should learn now itself thoroughly. You have to keep it in your mind. Four boundaries of India. Northern side. Northern side, Himalaya mountain. Himalaya mountain. Southern side of northern side after southern side. Indian Ocean. Indian Ocean. Now which are the two sides left? East and west. Eastern side? Somebody is telling something. Eastern side? Very good. Bay of Bengal. Bay of Bengal. And western side? Very good. First you know, western side, Arabian Sea. These are the four boundaries of India. These are the four boundaries of India. India is in the middle of these four things. Northern side, Himalaya Mountain. Southern side, Indian Ocean. Eastern side, Bay of Bengal. And western side, Arabian Sea. India is in the middle of this. The area in the middle of these things are known as India or our country. Okay. Boundaries of India, don't forget it. Okay. You should keep it in your mind. If anyone asks which are the four boundaries of India, immediately you have to say directions and boundaries. Is it clear? Okay. It is clear. Now you look here. Look here. This map. You can see, already I said this is north. So the areas from north to east. This area is known as northeast. North and east. 29 states are there. Out of these 29 states, 18 states are located in the northeast side of India. Northeastern side of India. North to east. North you can see. Which one is, which state is this one? Which state is this one? Jammu Kashmir. Jammu Kashmir and Nagaland, Manipur, like that. 18 states are located in the north to eastern side of India. Again, how many states are left? 11 states. Out of this 11 state, Madhya Pradesh and Chhattisgarh is in the middle of India. Madhya Pradesh and Chhattisgarh is in the middle of India. All the other states, Kerala, Tamil Nadu, Karnataka, Andhra Pradesh, Gujarat, Goa and all comes in the west, south, south and western side of India. Isn't clear? 18 states are there in the north to eastern side. Chhattisgarh and Madhya Pradesh is in the middle. Other states are in the this side, west and southern side of India. Okay. Is it clear? That is why only I told first I told you should learn directions. North, south, east, west you learn. So it is easy for you to understand. 18 states are there in the north to east. The remaining states are here. Okay, is it clear? Is it clear? Okay, very good. Which states are in the middle of India? Middle of India? Very good. Madhya Pradesh and Chhattisgarh. Then our Kerala. Where is the location of Kerala? Kerala is located in the east or west or south or where it is located? Very good. Kerala is located in the southernmost part of India. Which are the neighboring states of Kerala? Neighboring states, nearer states of Kerala. Kerala is in the southernmost of India. And which are the neighboring states? Tamil Nadu, Karnataka, Andhra Pradesh. Isn't it? These are the neighboring states of Kerala. Then, which is the smallest state you know? Smallest state you can see here. Here in the western side, one small dot is there. What is the name of that state? Very good, very good. It is Goa. Goa is the smallest state. Then biggest state which one? Biggest one? What is this? Very good. Uttar Pradesh. Okay. More population. Very good. So you have understood about the states. Then now, how many union territories were there? 7 union territories. That we will discuss. Okay. The concept about the state is clearer now. Any doubt? Any doubt about the state? Any doubt? No doubt about the state. Then, do you know the names of all the states? All the states' names. Suppose I say the alphabet A. Which are the states starting with A? States starting with A. Very good. Assam, Arunachal Pradesh, again Andhra Pradesh. Isn't it? These are the three states starting with the alphabet A. Very good. Then with the alphabet K, which are the states starting with the alphabet K? Our state's name you said. That is starting with Kerala. Kerala is starting with what? K. Again, Karnataka. Neighboring states of Kerala is also starting with K. So, you should learn in such a way. Alphabetical order, if you learn, it will be very good. If you learn the states starting with C, starting with D. If you learn in such a way, means it will be very easy for you to remember the state's name. You try to learn in such a way, okay? And here, I'm showing. You can see this one. States which are in the north, which are in east, south and west. States which are in south, north, east, west. You can see it. Okay. Then here union territories with their capitals. 7 union territories with their capitals. Which are the union territories? Union territories name? Any idea about you? Have you heard about the union territories? Union territories you heard, I explained. But do you know the names of union territories? No. Okay, very good. Andaman Nicobar Islands. Andaman Nicobar Islands. Have you heard that one? Have you heard about Andaman Nicobar Islands? Somebody is telling you have heard it. Very good. Then, Andaman Nicobar Islands capital is which one? Port Blair is the capital. Next one is Dadra and Nagar Haveli, Chandigarh, Daman and Diu, Lakshadweep, Delhi and Pondicherry. These are the 7 union territories of India. As I told you, all the 29 states and 7 union territories, they have got their own capitals. So that's a task for you to find out all the capitals. The states I have given, you have to find out all the 29 states capitals and 7 union territories capital. Okay, are you ready? Ready or not? Yes, you are ready. I know you will do. So you have to find out all the 29 capitals and union territories capital. That's 7 capitals also. Okay. Then next, in our workbook. Workbook, what is there to do? S1 and S2, that is also same thing. States and capitals. Different clues are given there. Some important features of the states are given as clue. Then by reading that clue, you have to understand which state it is. You can do it. See, S1 and S2, what is the first question? I am in the northernmost tip of country. China is to my east and Pakistan is to my west in the winter. I am covered with snow. Who am I? Northernmost. Which is the northernmost state? You can see in the map which is the northernmost state. Jammu Kashmir. So in such a way, read the clues and find out the states. Okay. That is S1 and S2. Then here S2, another page, one India map is given. You have to locate all the states here. Locate the states. That is the north and eastern states of India, southern, central and western states and 2 union territories. You have to locate here. This is the work assigned for you. 2 tasks are there. Complete S1 and S2. Again, find out all the capitals of union territories and states. Are you ready to do? Yes or no? Will you do? Yeah, yes. It is very easy. Very good. You yourself are saying it is very easy. We will do within half an hour. Very good. Very good. Very good. So, if you try, half an hour is also not needed. Before that, you can complete. So, try to complete. And notes and all, up to date, you have to keep. Okay. Last week, I had given that fourth block's answer. I shared that fourth block's answer now. All of you have copied. Yes or no? Those who have not copied, copy that answers. And up to date notes and all up to date you keep. Any doubts, you ask to me. Interaction time or otherwise you can ask to me personally. Everything must be up to date. Any topic or any point if you have not understand, you should ask me and everything has to be cleared. Don't keep any doubts in your mind. Okay. So today we will bind up. We will be meeting again with the continuation of this block. Till then, take care. Stay safely at home. Do all the works and be good children. Bye-bye.